Welcome to the 2020 Absolute Classics Festival. I want to take this chance to say a huge thank you to the Trusts and Foundations, sponsors, and individual donors who helped make these concerts happen. A special thanks goes to Austin Friars School for their sponsorship of tonight's performance. Austin Friars continues to be the first choice school for parents considering independent day education in Cumbria and Southwest Scotland, and offers more than just excellent academic education. Both staff and pupils appreciate that the school life extends far beyond the classroom, and extracurricular activities are a strong facet of Austin Friars' all-round education, which equips pupils not just with knowledge, but with skills for life. Further information can be found on the school website. You too can support Absolute Classics by checking out the description section below. This evening's concert is given by piano showman Tim Abel. I first met Tim a number of years ago when we both studied at the RNCM in Manchester. And since then, his career has taken him all over the world and recently has been performing a show on cruise ships. I know you're going to enjoy the arrangements of the music that he has made. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show.
Good evening and welcome to the 2020 Absolute Classics Festival. My name's Tim Abel and I'm recording from Home Firth in West Yorkshire tonight. Now, our first piece was Billy Joel's Root Beer Rag. Now, first of all, I'd like to say a big thank you to Alex McQuiston and all the team at Absolute Classics for making this concert happen tonight, and a special thanks to Austin Friars High School in Carlisle for sponsoring this event. Now, if you would like to yourself make a donation, please follow the links at the bottom of the screen. And don't forget to follow Absolute Classics on social media so you keep updated with all their future events. Now, tonight's concert is just a very laid-back, fun programme, really. It's just artists and music that have inspired me over my life. And I'd like to next play a piece by the great George Gershwin. This is a song taken from his musical, Crazy for You. It was this is arranged by the American composer Earl Wild, and this is called Embraceable You. Thank you. Yeah, I'm exhausted after that. That was quite a workout. Well, last year there was a huge film that came out featuring the music of Elton John. It was a huge hit, and I thought at the time it'd be a good idea to create my own medley of Elton John songs. Now, I normally have a show that I go and take out on cruise ships, so when I normally play this piece, I've got an eight-piece band behind me, but I actually realised that the piano part works quite well just played on its own. So if you're a fan of the Rocket Man, then hopefully you're going to enjoy this next selection of pieces. This is my very own Elton John medley. Thank you. Thank you very much. Well, I hope you enjoyed that. And you might notice that I stuck in a little bit of Disney there, The Circle of Life from The Lion King. I'm going to follow up with another Disney piece now for you. This is a ragtime version of The Bare Necessities from The Jungle Book. A piano concert without something from perhaps the greatest piano showman of the 20th century. I'm talking about a very flamboyant gentleman from Palm Springs, California. Now, when he was alive, he was the richest man in show business, and he had a swimming pool in the shape of a piano. Of course, I'm talking about the one and only Liberace. Now, this next piece, he based it on a very simple tune that I can imagine almost everyone has sat down at the piano at some point and tried to play in their lives, because it's a very simple tune. You can play it with just two fingers, or if you really liked, a pair of chopsticks. Thank you. Well, some of you really up to date with your classical music might have noticed that he slipped in a couple of quotes from Liszt and Rachmaninoff in that piece. So I'm going to follow on with that. I'm going to actually play you a piece by Rachmaninoff. And this is the 18th variation on the theme of Paganini. Now, Rachmaninoff wrote a series of variations for piano and orchestra based on this variation on Paganini. Sorry, this theme from Paganini. And what he did is, for this 18th variation, he took this part and he inverted it. And he took it from a minor key into a major key. And then he transposed it up into the key of D flat, creating this. I'm sure most of you know that tune. So here we go. This is Rachmaninoff's 18th variation on a theme of Paganini. Well, I'm afraid that's just about all I've got time for. I've got one more piece left for you. But if you would like to hear a bit more of my playing, I've got an album. It's called Tim Abel Piano Showman, and it's on Spotify. It's on Apple Music. You can buy it on iTunes, or if you'd like a CD, you can visit my website, which is timabelpianoshowman.com, and order yourself a copy. And all those proceeds are going to go to a very good cause, and it's a foundation that I've set up myself. It's called the Tim Abel Piano Steinway Fund. So it's a very good cause indeed, and it really does need a lot more work, as you can see. But anyway, I'm going to finish off with a piece by Rimsky-Korsakov originally, The Flight of the Bumblebee, but you may not have heard this arrangement of it before. It's a boogie-woogie by Hans Otterhal, and it's called The Bumble Boogie. Thank you very much, and good night.